Now let us see the working of motor. Till now we have seen the construction of motor. The construction of motor is ABCD is a rectangular coil of insulated copper wire which is mounted between the north and south poles of a permanent magnet. The ends A and D are soldered or connected to split copper rings P and Q. X and Y are the carbon brushes. These are the carbon brushes. These carbon brushes are connected to a battery, okay, through a plug key K. Okay. Now see here, I have drawn this 2D diagram. In your book you have a 3D diagram, and in your your fair book, you have to draw the 3D diagram which is given in the book. Now this I have drawn just so that it becomes easier for you all to understand the working of motor. Okay. Now see here, when the plug key K is switched on, the current starts flowing. The current always leaves the positive terminal of the battery and enters the negative terminal of the battery. As a result, the current flows like this, and in the coil ABCD, it moves along A to B and then B to C and C to D and so on. Okay, now what you see is the current in the arms AB and CD is moving in opposite directions. Now you know the magnetic field will always be from the north pole to south pole. So you can see the arms AB and CD are perpendicular to the magnetic field. As a result, they will experience mechanical force acting on them based on the principle of motor. And what is the principle of motor? A current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field will experience mechanical force. And the direction of mechanical force is given by motor rule or Fleming's left hand rule. Now according to Fleming's left hand rule, if you apply, see, the magnetic field is downwards. For AB, the current is moving in the left forward direction. If you apply, what you come to know is AB is pushed out of the page and CD as a result will be pushed inwards inside the page. As a result, a couple will be acting on them. Couple means two equal parallel forces which are separated by some distance. As a result, the arm AB will move upwards and CD will move downwards. As a result, the coil ABCD will start rotating in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, and it will complete half rotation. After the completion of half rotation, what happens is the CD comes up, AB comes down. I have drawn it here. CD comes up, AB comes down. Now since D has come up and A has come down, okay, D and A are connected to copper rings, split rings, P and Q. As a result, Q comes in contact with the carbon brush X, P comes in contact with the carbon brush Y. Now here, the direction of current will be in this direction. See, the direction of current in the coil will be along DCBA. Since the current flows in the direction DCBA, what we come to know is that now the arm CD will be again pushed up, BA will be pushed down. That is, the direction of the couple acting will be the same. As a result, the coil ABCD will start rotating in the same anti-clockwise direction. This is how the motor works. See once again, when you switch on the key, the current will flow like this. That is, current leaves the positive terminal of the battery, reaches the carbon brush X, then the copper split ring P, and it moves along ABCD in the rectangular coil. In the upper arm AB, it is moving leftwards current, and in the lower arm it is moving rightwards. As a result, these two arms will experience equal and opposite forces. That is, AB will be pushed out upwards, CD will be pushed downwards. As a result, the coil will start rotating. After completion of the first half rotation, okay, what will happen is CD will come up and AB will come down. Okay, so D was connected to Q, A was connected to P. As a result, Q will now come in contact with carbon brush X, P will come in contact with carbon brush Y. P and Q are copper split rings. That is, one ring is cut into two halves. Now, the current will be flowing in the second half rotation. The current will be flowing along DCBA. Okay, and if you apply again Fleming's left hand rule, the upper arm will be pushed out of the page, the lower arm will be pushed downwards. Here also, upper arm was pushed upwards and out of the page, the lower arm was pushed inwards. So here, during the second half rotation also, the direction of the couple acting will be in the same direction. As a result, the motor starts rotating. This is how an electric motor works. Okay, a simple electric motor works in this way.